So you've just finished a project with your ATEM Mini Pro ISO, and all the cuts you made during the live show are stored inside this handy little DaVinci Resolve project file, which is great for Resolve editors, but if you're a Premiere editor like me, the first thing you do when you sit down to edit is export the timeline to an XML and import that into Premiere. But now there's a problem. These clips on the timeline are not multi-camera clips. They're individual, single-camera clips, so you can't click on one and just change the camera angle. And this isn't just a limitation of Premiere. The clips on the timeline in Resolve are the exact same. They're not multi-camera either. But Resolve gets around this with their sync bin feature, which is a sort of roundabout way of doing the same thing. But this feature does not exist in Premiere Pro. But what if you didn't need it? What if there was a way to turn all these single-camera clips into multi-camera clips? Well, with this auto-hotkey script that I've created, you can do just that. First, my apologies to Mac users, since auto-hotkey is only available on Windows. It's a very powerful piece of software that can execute sequences of keystrokes for you, and we can use it to solve our multi-camera problem. Once that program is installed, download the script I wrote in the description. We're not quite ready to run it yet, though. We're going to need to do some minimal setup inside of Premiere first. First, let's create a multi-camera clip based on the ISO footage, which should have already been imported when you dragged in your XML. I found that these settings work best. Next, create a new track to put this multi-camera clip on, and make sure the new track is directly above V1. Make sure any graphics you might have are moved up to V3. Now, you might be able to guess what we're going to do here. Using auto hotkey and a series of looping keyboard shortcuts, we're going to automatically make cuts on V2 that mirror the cuts on V1 exactly. Except this time, they'll be multi-camera cuts. To do this, we need to make sure we have the right keyboard shortcuts configured. Create a new keyboard profile based on Adobe's default and add these three keyboard shortcuts. Map Rename Clip to F2. Then, map Toggle Target Video 1 to Ctrl-Shift-1 and Toggle Target Video 2 to Ctrl-Shift-2. Name this something like ATEM Cutter and you're good to go. Next, we need to figure out how many clips we have on our timeline so we can tell the script how many times it needs to loop. You can do this by opening the Info window and then selecting all the clips on the timeline. The number that appears is the number of clips. Now, let's run the script by double-clicking on it. You'll notice that nothing happened, except for a little H that appeared in your system tray. This means that our script is running, but it's waiting for us to press the hotkey that will start the cutting process. I've mapped this to the /backtick button, usually found right next to the 1 on the keyboard, but don't press it yet, because there's one more important step, and that's to deactivate all your video and audio tracks, getting rid of those little blue squares. Once that's done, make sure the blue box is around your timeline panel and press the tilde button. You'll be asked to input the number of clips you have. In my case, it's 218. And now the process begins of automatically cutting everything on V2. It's somewhat slow, but it's completely automatic. I'm not pressing anything on my keyboard right now. The script even gives you a little estimate of how long this process might take. I'm going to speed up the process for the purposes of this video, and you can see that when we're done, we have a timeline of cuts on V2 that mirror the cuts on V1 exactly, but now the camera angles of these cuts can be easily changed via the multi-camera interface and keyboard shortcuts. If I toggle the visibility of V2 on and off, you can see that the frame lines up exactly with V1. And since we really don't need these single camera clips anymore, I usually just delete the track altogether. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope this speeds up your ATEM ISO post-production process by a great deal. Thank you for watching.